Let's welcome Jeremy and the Capella team to talk about bringing the power of YouTube to your games.
All right. Hi, my name is Jeremy Walker. I'm a developer advocate here at Google. And as he said, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about bringing the power of YouTube to games. But before I got started, I always like to start with a demo. And that's what we're doing here with Capella today. So if you're anything like me, you like to get your friends together in a living room and talk some smack and play some games. But you can't really do that with mobile games, right? You can do that with consoles. But the thing that's kind of missing is playing in real time against each other and then being able to share your screen, so kind of two items. Luckily for us, the first one's taken care of. We're playing an Android game called Riptide GPT-2. I don't know if you guys have heard this game. It's pretty fun. It's a racing game, and they've integrated with the Google Play Game Services API to enable that real-time playing with each other. But to take it a step further and share it, Capella put something together where we're actually outputting from both of these phones to Capella, and they're doing a little magic with some green screens and stuff, and then we're sharing it up to YouTube on the live stream. So we have our gamers here, and they're playing the games. Say hello, guys, if you can. Kyle and David, and then we have Kuyo over here. She's running the studio. It's called Cambria Live. It's by Capella. And then they're using our live streaming API to stream it up to YouTube. So if the Wi-Fi is working and the gods are with us, I should be able to see this live. Please stand by. Okay, so the Wi-Fi is not with us today. Well, that's okay, because we actually figured this would happen.
This probably means the Wi-Fi at Moscone wasn't quite up to par. We figured this might happen, so we wanted to record it ahead of time to let you see that, yes, this does work. So we still have the same gamers. You can see they're playing right behind me. They're live, and Akiyo is working in Cambria from Capella, editing this all together and streaming it up to YouTube. And you can see behind me that they're actually playing in real time. So hopefully this gives you some ideas of how you can use the YouTube APIs with your mobile games. And back to you, Jeremy.
All right. So maybe next time. But you can see that it works. We thought that was pretty cool. So hopefully that's kind of got your feeling a little more awake. And now I'll jump into the slides, and hopefully I won't put you to sleep. But I basically have three things to cover today. I'm going to cover why you should use YouTube with your mobile games. How to do it with a replay, that's just like playing back a highlight from your game, and then live. And then the last part is a review. So I always like to start with this number. So we released this a little while ago, so it's a little higher now, but we get 1 billion unique users per month on YouTube. So that's a lot of people that are coming to YouTube to watch content. And one of our biggest categories is gaming. So a lot of people are coming to YouTube just specifically for gaming. And you guys probably know this. You've probably gone there to check out some gameplay videos yourself. But what I wanted to do is kind of take a step back and think of this presentation a little bit differently, maybe from your aspect. And so I talked to some people. And the one thing that seemed to come up a lot for gamers is, how do I get my game to stand out? And so that's what I'm going to kind of look at today. Let's forget the stuff where you follow style guidelines and all that stuff to get yourself promoted, maybe within the Play Game Store or whatever, or the App Store. We're going to look at stuff that can influence you. So let's take a step back and look. Let's say you're developing a game. And usually when I talk to game developers, you know, they may have like something like video sharing on the list of things to do. But as you guys know, when you get closer to launching, whether that's a new game or a new feature, you know, you probably, something took longer than you thought it would, and you have to cut things. And maybe you have to decide between a new level and enabling video sharing or something like that. And it usually gets cut. And what people tell me is like, well, a minority of our users actually use it. So we didn't think it was worthwhile. We thought the extra level or something like that would be better. And so I actually looked into that. And you'd be right. Only 10 to 20% of users, mobile game users, find that feature to be very important. And this was from a study that Amplifier did last year. So this is sharing. So, and what they meant by this, it doesn't mean like sharing your high score or saying, hey, I like this game. It means sharing a screen, three things, sharing a screenshot, but more importantly, sharing video replay or live video. So that's this 10 to 20% said it's very important. And what this survey wanted to try to figure out was, you know, is it worth going after these people or is it not? So again, this was mobile gamers only, the study, but they dove into a lot of questions and they separated that out. So what they did is they took that group of people and they labeled them sharers, and then they figured out how do they compare to the non-sharers. Now again, both are mobile game players. And what they found is pretty interesting. So first, sharers download and try more games per month. They actually play more per week, more hours per week. They make more purchases, which is great, right? That's in-app in the games themselves. And then lastly, they're more social. So they want to share their gameplay experiences with people, not only online, but offline. They want to recommend them, which is also a great thing. So you're probably thinking, okay, so they're this subset that's a little bit more important. That makes sense, but I'm still on the fence. Like, it still doesn't seem like it's worth the work. And this one's pretty obvious, but mobile gamers watch game videos. So in the survey, they asked them a bunch of questions, and there's a couple that came up that I thought were really important. And this was one of them. So 65% of people, of mobile gamers, watch video gameplay. 80% of the sharers watched it as well. So they were a bit higher. But what's really interesting there is they broke out the categories. They didn't just say video gameplay. They said, you know, live streaming, trailers, video gameplay. And video replay or watching actual gameplay was rated number one. It was actually rated above trailers. So think about that for a second. People, it's more important to them to watch the gameplay than these $1,000 or $1 million trailers that are put out. So keep that in the back of your head. And then what really kind of drove this home for me was this other question that I found was, when a mobile gamer goes and watches a gameplay clip, what's their number one action afterwards? And what they found was that 45% of the time they download a game. That was number one. Number two was they would share it or refer it. And then number three was they'd continue researching. So think about that for a second. They're making these for free, these gameplay videos. They have a high click-through rate. I mean, you're spending money making these trailers, and these free things are watched more and have a good click-through rate. Like, why aren't you taking advantage of it? That's what I like to say. So hopefully that at least gets you thinking about, yeah, there is a minority of users, but they are gonna generate a lot of videos for me that have a lot of ads for me that have high click-through rates. So that's something to think about. And then again, with the YouTube APIs, we allow you to do some extra thing, like in the description, you can set a link to your store link so they can click right there and get right to it. So there's a lot of good things you can do there. Anyway, hopefully that kind of gives you an idea of why you'd want to do it. So now I'm going to give you some examples of how it was done, both in replay and live. So any of you guys play football? Not American football, obviously. So actually, FIFA did this in 2013 in their game on iOS. They actually do it in the newer one, too. But they allow you to share out to YouTube. So if you score a goal, you can share that. And one of my Polish colleagues was playing as Poland, and he was pretty excited here. He scored a goal. So he wanted to share that experience. And what they let you do is they let you go back and change the camera angle so you can make it a little bit more interesting. And then you can see there, in the lower right, after he scores, you can click on a button there to upload it to YouTube. And the first time you go through, obviously, it asks you, you know, do you want to upload this to your account? And you can. And then on the right side, you can actually see the screenshot of this actual gameplay up on YouTube. What you don't see there is the description, which points back so that anybody that comes to see this and likes this can click through right there and install the game. Any of you guys have kids? Yeah, well, if you do, you probably heard this game, Talking Tom. So this is a little game where you talk to it, and it reads it back to you in a funny voice, and it has a whole bunch of animals. It's got some really, really funny things that people have done with it, whether they're singing or comedy bits. I suggest you check it out. I can't show it here because I'd probably get in trouble with HR. But definitely check it out. And they actually integrated, you can see on the upper left there, they integrated a little record button so you can record your interactions. And they actually have accounted for 1.4 million interactions uploaded to YouTube. But what's more interesting is they're getting over 25 million views per month. I think they said they had 800 million views so far. So think about that. A couple of these videos have hundreds of thousands of views. Like, they're making stuff and it's going viral, and Talking Tom is taking advantage of that. So anyway, hopefully that gets you thinking a little bit about that. So how did they do that? So there's basically two parts to sharing video on from your game. One part is kind of separate from YouTube, and the other part is with YouTube. So I'm going to go through kind of a high view because we don't have a lot of time, but the first thing you're going to want to do, and this example is using Unity, so you need to get the basically create a video. That's step one. So you need to grab the audio and video frames. You need to pipe them through something that'll encode them for you. You can use WebM or maybe FFmpeg if that's better for you. In this case, encoding to VP8 for the video, and then Vorbis for the audio, and then you put it in a container like WebM, and then bam, you have your video file. Now is when our APIs step in. And you can use, we have tons of client libraries in all the major languages, and we've written samples in all of them, so it's pretty easy for you to just go pick up an API sample, make some minor modifications, and you're pretty much ready to go. So that's pretty much it. It's a RESTful API, but again, we have client libraries to handle a lot of this for you. Now, let's say that's a lot of work, and you're like, I don't want to make the videos. There's actually companies out there that do this for you. So EverPlay is a good example. They actually provide an SDK where they do everything for you. So they make the video, and then they allow you to the user to upload to YouTube. And they've done this for a lot of games. And I'm sure you guys recognize this one. This is one. And then there's another company called Camcord that does the same thing. They have a bunch of games as well. Trial Extreme 3 is one. So if you do a really cool trick, you can share it up. And again, these are just SDKs that you add to your game, and they take care of all this for you. So at least for replay, hopefully that gives you a little bit of an idea of some of the things you can do. So live is a little bit different. We have a couple people that do it. So Elgato is a big one. They're actually separate hardware, but they allow you to stream live from their device up to YouTube. You can do it with a console or with mobile. If you want to do something a little bit more, like you saw here with Capella, they have a live studio where you can do all sorts of crazy stuff with the green screen, crop out people, put text, and then live stream right up. Wow, how did they do that? So this one is actually our live streaming API. Pretty straightforward. There's three main parts to it, really probably only two you'll be using, but you create a broadcast, bind a stream to it, and you're pretty much set. There is a cue point, but that's for ads, and not everyone uses that. So anyway, that hopefully gives you some ideas for replay and live. You could do some live stuff on the device with the new version of Android and screen sharing. You can do some stuff with that, but you do have to be aware that it's obviously pretty, encoding a video can be kind of hard on a phone, so you got to be careful about how you do it. And if you're interested in finding about more details about replay and doing that, we do have an I/O talk where we go much more into detail on that. So, review. Empower your sharers. Yes, they are a minority, but they spend more money, they find more games, and they'll share it. They'll make these free advertisements for you that have good click-through rates, and they're more important to the mobile gamers than trailers. Now, I'm not saying trailers aren't important. They are important, but gameplay is even more important. Three times. So this, just in the last year, subscriptions for gaming channels have tripled in the last year. So gaming is a huge deal on YouTube. Take advantage of it. If you want to find out more about the tools, just go on your favorite search engine and search YouTube API. It'll probably be the first thing that shows up. We have samples, libraries, all that great stuff. And if you want to follow more information on YouTube and the developer community, just go to YouTube. Oh, sorry. youtube.com/dev, and we have a Google Plus and Twitter handle, so thank you. Oh, we have some extra swag too, so after the next presentation, if you want to get some stickers and pins for free, come on up. Thank you.